Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam amma ba'd. Habita fillah, I wanted to mention something very important, as so many brothers and some sisters have expressed desires to seek knowledge. And this is khair azim. This is khair azim. This is a great, a beautiful thing. But I want to mention something which is so important, and that is sincerity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ikhlas. Because if your talab al-ilm is not mabni ala ikhlas, that means you didn't have sincerity and try your best to remain sincere and come back to sincerity even when you go get away from it, then you will be nuqs. You will have shortcomings in your seeking of knowledge, and your outcome will be nuqs, will be have shortcomings. And so, in fact, we can even go to the extent of saying that some people, they sought knowledge and they became from Ahl al-Dalal, they became from Ahl al-Bidah. And some people sought knowledge and they left the deen. And that shows you, habati fillah, that the ibrah is not just seeking knowledge, but it's going back to the hadith of Umar bin al-Khattab radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم يقول إنما أعمال بالنيات وإنما لكل امرئ ما نوى فمن كانت هجرته إلى الله ورسوله فهجرته إلى الله ورسوله ومن كانت هجرته للدنيا يصيبها امرأة ينكحها فهجرته إلى ما هاجر إليه رواه شيخان. The hadith of Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, where he said, verily actions are tied to the intentions, where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, verily actions are tied to the intentions, and everyone shall get that for which he intended. Therefore, he who migrates for Allah and his messenger, then he has migrated for Allah and his messenger. And he who migrates to take some woman in marriage or for some worldly gain, then he has migrated, then he will get that for which he migrated for him. And this is in Bukhari and Muslim. Ahabati fillah, that shows us that when we even seek knowledge, that we should have sincerity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to have sincerity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you're seeking this knowledge not to be on the minbar. You're seeking this knowledge not to be in front of the people. You're seeking this knowledge not because you want a nice salary, which most of the people who do da'wah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the West don't get nice salaries, except for usually in the Ahl al-Bidah. But if you're from Ahl al-Sunnah, a lot of times you don't see that. And I'm not saying all of Ahl al-Sunnah, but I'm just saying a lot of times it's the wealthier masajid or Jamaat al-Tabliq and Ikhwan al-Muslimin and those other communities that realize the importance of taking care of their youth, even the Sufis. And so it's important to have your intention for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that it's sincerely, that it's an act of ibadah. Because we know ibadah is built upon two conditions. What are those two conditions of ibadah? Ikhlas wa mutaba, sincerity to Allah, and that you follow the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And we know that talab al-ilm can actually lead you to the hellfire. Wa kayfa thalik ya Aba Abdurrahman? How is that? How is that, you ask? Akramakum Allah. That comes from the hadith. I believe it's Ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma, who said, سَمِعْتُ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ يَقُولُ إِنَّ الْأَوَّلَ النَّاسِ يُقْضَى عَلَيْهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ رَجْلٌ أُسْتُشِدَ فَأُتِيَ بِهِ فَعَرَفُهُ نِعَمُهُ فَعَرَفَهَا فقال له وما عملت فيها قال قتلت فيك واستشهدت وكما قال. He said that some of the Prophet ﷺ said that from the first people on the Day of Judgment that will be judged is a man who was martyred, and he will be brought before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he will be asked, وَمَا عَمَلْتَ فِيهَا? And what did you do? And he will say, قَتَلْتُ فِيكَ حَتَّى أَسْتُشْهِدَ. I fought for your sake until I was martyred. قَالَ كَذَّبْتَ. And it will be said to him, Allah will say, you lied. وَلَكِنَّكَ فَعَلْتَ لِيَقَالْ هُوَ جريء فقد قيل ثم أمر به فصحب على وجهه حتى ألقي في النار. But rather you lied in order that the people would say that you are a martyr. And it was said. So he got his natija. He got his end result. He got his praise he wanted. He wanted praise in the dunya. That's what he got. But what about the akhirah? Allah called him a kadhab, a liar. Can you imagine your Lord calling you a kadhab? What can you say after that? Who can you have an argument and debate about after that? No one. No one can help you. No one can assist you. Your Lord knows everything about you. He created you. He knows what you did, what you will do, what you could have done. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it was said that you lied, but rather you did it so that the people would say that you were a brave person. And they said it. Then he was dragged in the hellfire by his forelock. Dragged on the face in the hellfire. The second man. Then there was another man brought before the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. فقال فما عملت فيها قال قرأت القرآن وعلمته أو قرأت فيك القرآن. قال كذبت. And I'm giving a paraphrase of the hadith because unfortunately I've forgotten it. Bits and pieces. So the second man on the day of judgment, according to this hadith of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who brought be brought for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it will be asked, فَمَا عَمَلْتَ فِيهَا قَالَ تَعَلَّمْتَ الْعِلْمُ وَعَلَّمْتُهُ وَقَرَأْتَ فِيكُ الْقُرْآنِ. He said, I sought knowledge and I taught it. And I read and taught the Quran for your sake. قَالَ كَذَّبْتْ. Allah will say you lied. وَلَكِنَّكَ فَعَلْتَ لِيُقَالْ هُوَ عَالِمٌ وَقَرَاتَ لِيُقَالْ هُوَ قَارِئٌ فَقَدْ قِيلْ. You lied, but rather you did it so the people would say you are a person of knowledge, أهل العلم. And you did it so that the people would say you are a beautiful reciter. And they did. فَقَدْ قِيلْ ثُمَّ أُمِرَ بِهِ فُسُحِبَ عَلَى وَجِهِ حَتَّى أُلْقِيَ فِي النَّارِ. And then it will be commanded that he will be dragged upon his face into the hellfire. وَعِيَاذَ بِاللَّهِ وَإِيَّاكُمْ مِنَ النَّارِ. And then the third man is one who was given wealth. وَعْتَامُهُ مِنْ أَسْنَافِ الْمَالِ كُلِّ. This one, he was given wealth and he spent it in every... He spent the wealth in every means that he could for your sake. This is what he said, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's brought before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he's saying that he spent wealth for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he tells, you know, he said, مَا تَرَكْتُ مِنْ سَبِيلَ أَنْ يَنْفَقَ فِيهَا إِلَّا أَنْفَقْتُ فِيكَ لَكْ. I didn't take, there wasn't a way in which I could have spent money except that I did it for your sake. And Allah will say, كذبت. You lied. وَلَكِنَّكَ فَعَلْتَ لِيَقَالْ هُوَ جَوَادٌ فَقَدْ كِيلْ ثُمَّ أُمِرَ بِهِ ثُمَّ أُلْكِيَ ثُمَّ سُحِبَ عَلَى وَجْهِ ثُمَّ أُلْكِيَ فِي النَّارِ. The Prophet ﷺ said, this one, Allah will say, you lied. But rather you did it so the people would say you were a spendthrift, or there's a term for the one who spends all of his wealth. I forgot what they call that. You were one of these, you know, a person who spends all their wealth, anyhow, who spends all their money at the end of death or what have you. That you were, you know, this is a person who is, who's praiseworthy, even amongst the non-Muslims. That's praiseworthy. They look at, okay, Bill Gates is going to give all his wealth away. Jeff Bezos of Amazon is going to do this, and this one's going to do this, and Prince so-and-so and King so-and-so is going to give away this. This is a praiseworthy characteristic. But Allah will tell this person that you lied, but rather you did it so that the people would praise you and say that you're a high roller, a spender, big spender in the car, and for my sake. And rather it was said, meaning that he got his praise in the dunya, and then he will be thrown on his face and dragged in the hellfire by his forelock. And so, Ahabati Fillah, sorry to take out so much of your time, but the Ibra, the main point that I wanted to emphasize with this hadith and the other ahadith, is that when seeking knowledge, part of your preparation is really that you have a sincere intention to Allah, that you're doing it to come closer to Allah. You're doing it to better your ibadah. You're doing it to remove the jahil, the ignorance from yourself. You're doing it to qarraban ila Allah azza wa jal. You're doing it in order to come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but not to come closer to the people, not to be praised by the people, not to strive for the people, not to do it for the dunya, because then in the end, maybe all you will get is some dunya and some praise. Think about those dawah organizations, that they're big dawah organizations now. Many people praise them, many people defend them in their batil, in their falsehood. And many of the people of Ahl Bid'ah that have these characteristics, the people praise them, but what about the hereafter? What are they going to get? Are they going to earn from that talib al-ilm, or that intishar al-ilm, that spreading of dawah, because it was dawah al-hizbiyah? Dawah al-kufr wa shirk, dawah al-bid'ah, are they going to get the dawah al-Allah and the ajr from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil and bless us with ilm al-nafiyah wa rizq al-tayyibah wa amal al-mutaqabbilin wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.